I started seeing elements of myself in Mathilde that frightened me, frankly. I mean, she had so much rage, right? So much rage. And I see this in myself, and I see this in a lot of my friends,
too. What
could
you have rage about?
Oh, well,
one thing you have rage about.
Well, it's not so much that I am unusual in my rage, it's that women are not necessarily allowed access, open access to our fury. Yeah.
Wait, stop.
Yes.
Women are not necessarily allowed open access to their fury.
Right.
Tell me what that means.
I will tell you an anecdote. So I sat at this table with, not this one, but a different one, with my friends. We are out having drinks. And I thought, you know what? All of you, you are all just boiling under with rage, with so much rage. And as I said this, they all turned on me and they said, that's so not true. So they got furious that I even mentioned their fury.
And you knew you struck gold.
I knew I struck gold. Because I think that we get boxed into these perceptions of femininity, right? If you scream at someone, you become I can't say the word, but you become.
Yes, you can.
Can I say bitch?
Yes.
All right.
It's crazy.
Yeah, you become, you know, you get called names. I mean, there's so much shaming for female rage, and we are human beings like men are, but men can yell at other people. Men can get into fights.
So what was the rage about, though, with these women sitting around the table?
Feeling,
was it about them and their place and them and their relationships and them and their what, children?
Yeah, no, feeling pressure from society, right? I mean, feeling pressure to raise children in a certain way, to do also fulfilling work outside the house. Yeah, I mean, there's just so much, and it's also subtle and it's also small when one says it aloud like this, but it's actually, it can build up, right? And if there are no outlets, then it becomes really dangerous. And the thing that I also see is, because I'm steeped in books, it's a different language that I love and that I know, I see that the models of female rage in literature are self-harming, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, Anna Karenina, what does she do? She jumps in front of a train. You know, Emma Bovary, she eats poison, and it's a terrible, terrible death. I mean, even going back to the Greeks, Medea, right? Dido. I mean, all of the women, except for possibly Antigone, hurt themselves. Oh, no, Antigone does too. She hangs herself.
Yeah, that's right.
There we go.
Yeah, but is it driven by one powerful idea?
It's a very powerful narrative about women. Yes.
Yeah, but it clearly it is. But in all those fictional characters you mentioned, was their death driven by one powerful idea? Unrequited love. I mean, often love is at the core of it, isn't it?
I think a loss of freedom or an inability to be free is at the core of most of those people.
I think so too.
Right, right. And just a feeling of being caged in these invisible cages.